long tradition.
It's marvelous to have you here. And a bunch of faithful Presbyterians and committed. Join me, please, in a call to worship. Come, Son.
Tell the glory of the resurrected.
Come, Jesus, our Son of Righteousness.
Shine on life, magnified by divine grace.
Come, everyone.
Come,
and let us celebrate the resurrection.
Try to answer it anyway. When you sow a seed in the soil, you do not sow a grown plant, but a bare seed of wheat and whatever you want to grow. And so it is with the resurrection of the dead. The body is sown as perishable, but it rises as imperishable. It is buried in brokenness, but it rises in glory. It is buried in weakness, it rises in strength. It is buried as natural body, but it rises as spiritual body.
That's the word of God for us today. And dear friends, this is frankly the earliest description of resurrection in the Bible, in the New Testament. Apostle Paul is writing it around year 53. Gospels were written like 20, first gospel was written 20 years after that. So this is the oldest. Apostle Paul also, guessing from this scripture and some other, did not know anything about empty tomb. So he used this image. And that image is just absolutely splendid and beautiful. I have three reasons why I consider that to be splendid and beautiful. One is that it connects us with the most ancient stories of humankind, almost. Definitely of our culture or civilization. Going back to the beginning of agriculture, where they had these legends or even myths about the personified grain dying and rising. We know it from Greek mythology, we know it from Babylonian or Semitic mythology. There are European similar stories and legends, and here it is used, and Jesus himself used that in number of parables. About grain growing. Sometimes it is grain, sometimes it is seed, like a mustard seed. But it is the same principle. And I did an experiment or prepared our altar centerpiece for this Sunday. Over here, this is grown in my living room. And it was really eye-opening and transformative, I must say. Because just observing that those grains first the germs appearing, then starting to go up with those first leaves, and at the same time that very, very tiny hair, almost like a cotton web or something like that, spreading around, and then at the same time having the droplets on top of it, because that moisture from the ground was pushing through the leaves on the tops. So it is really a marvelous metaphor for resurrection. That's one thing. The other thing is that this metaphor of resurrection is also not only connecting us with the ancient civilizations and rooting our faith with them, but also it is connecting us with nature. And here environmentalists are absolutely right that main religions of the world became just concentrated on humans, forgetting about the nature around us. And these ancient stories reconnecting us with the nature around us are telling us our personal hopes in our faith are inseparable, like we are inseparable from the rest of the nature around us. I think it is very important part of a Christian message. And finally, the third thing is that this image is telling us it is not only about I. Because that one seed is growing into a plant to bring forth a corn of seeds, to share that with others. And Bible knows that, because in Gospel of John, there is a saying of ascribed there to Jesus, which says, unless the seed dies, it stays alone. When it is buried, it will not be alone. It will bring an abundant crop. And that's the third part, that it liberates us from self-absorption and looking around us, sharing our faith with others, and recognizing that we are integrated in deep history, integrated with the nature, and here for a purpose of those around us, our own as well, but those around us also. And that is our Easter message today, the oldest metaphor of resurrection. I find it beautiful and enriching.
All thy works with joy surround the earth and heaven reflect thy rays. Stars and angels sing around the center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, barren meadow, flashing sea.
So now join me in great thanksgiving. Abundance, dear friends, is on offer at this table. For as a multitude of grain and grapes are transformed into a loaf and cup, so the multitude of people of faith from all times and all traditions gather at the table of remembrance and joy.
Here we are nourished and restored.
Here wrongs are made right, here hurts are healed, here prejudice and injustices pass away. Here we are encircled by life and by the community of saints who call us out of the ordinary into the extraordinary that is the eternally transforming love of God.
Here we remember the Christ who rose like a sprouting grain, surprising his astonished disciples and bringing them words of encouragement. Here we can be certain we are welcome.
And so we take bread and break it.
Breaking the grip of death, breaking the darkness with morning light.
And we take wine and pour it.
It was miraculously transformed into the foretaste of eternity, heralding the hope of a new divine day.
Here, the healing and empowering Spirit of God dwells in these elements of bread and wine, and we are fed with good things. Things that produce a flourishing life, kindness, compassion, joy, and love. And we are grateful, saying together now, Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God in whom is heaven. May the hallowing of your name echo throughout the universe. May the way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. May your heavenly will be done by all created beings, and may your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From trials that are too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in a glory and a power that is love, now and forever. Amen. Cup of salvation. Cup of salvation. Now let us pray prayer after communion. We respond with gratitude, joy, and deep thankfulness. We give our lives to the promise of love, prepared to live it out and share its rising up in our midst. May it fully be so.
Lord, let's join the happy chorus, reach the morning stars begun. Love divine is reigning o'er us, joining all in heaven's plan. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife.
Let us hear and appropriate Lord's blessing. Lord bless you and keep you. Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. Lord shower you with favor and give you peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you for coming, everyone.
Christ
Thank you. Christ is risen indeed.